What if I can make sure that he never bothered you again?
How could you make sure? Hurt him? Kill him? Hampton, that's murder.
He never bothered you again.
Why would you do something like that?
To protect what's mine.
I'm yours?
Don't you want to be with me?
Sure, but...
But what?
It just seems so final.
Sometimes true freedom can only come with bloodshed. History's proven that time and time again.
Right.
If you want to take your destiny into your own hands for once and be free, then take my hand right now. If not, just walk away. But know that you will never be rid of this. It's up to you. Problem solved.
Brenda Walker. Chief Walker, since you've taken office, you've helped reduce crime in the city by 17%. How have you managed to do this at a time when the economy is in a slump and unemployment is rising?
We've managed to reduce crime by creating a series of community-based
Hello?
Programs. Hey, lady.
These programs
it's me.
Help give the residents Hampton. Options for better jobs, better social activities.
What do you want?
Damn, don't you want to talk to me?
No.
No?
That's right, no. Okay, you have some nerve calling here. I haven't heard from you in 4 months. You never came to visit me when I was in that shithole, and you didn't return any of my phone calls.
That's because I didn't want to see you caged up, baby.
Fuck you. I don't have anything to say to you.
Honey, I'm sorry. I just thought you might need a little space, that's all.
Okay, well, give me my space now.
Listen, I know stuff went bad in the past, but I'm trying to make you an offer.
What type of offer?
What if I told you we could split $1 million cash?
I would tell you to go.
Come on.
Yeah, who is it?
Sam.
Come on in.
See, you spared no expense on this place.
Yeah, well, I had to pick a spot that Mia would never come to.
So you got the game.
Oh, yeah. Philly's up by 10. They'll probably take the whole thing this year.
Thought you was a Bulls fan.
Well, I was when they had Jordan. I like the Sixers now.
If you were a true fan, it wouldn't matter if Jordan played or not.
All right, Hampson, what's up? You have the tape?
Yeah, I got the tape.
Well, where is it, my brother? Come on, don't keep me in suspense.
So, what happens now?
Once I make sure I have you two on tape fucking, it will prove her infidelity. And then I will file for divorce. Very, very simple.
So you just been like pretending so you can show the court that you tried to save the relationship, huh?
Right. Makes me look even more noble. If they see she had an affair with you, all the time, I was trying to salvage our love.
How could you make sure? Hurt him? Kill him? Hampton, that's murder.
He never bothered you again.
Why would you do something like that?
To protect what's mine.
I'm yours?
Don't you want to be with me?
Sure, but...
But what?
It just seems so final.
Sometimes true freedom can only come with bloodshed. History's proven that time and time again.
Right.
If you want to take your destiny into your own hands for once and be free, then take my hand right now. If not, just walk away. But know that you will never be rid of this. It's up to you.
A rich man.
Well, how rich? And when do I get my cut?
Hamp, like I told you, I get $3 million. You get half of that for helping me pull this off. You get paid when I do. This whole thing might be tied up in court for the next 6 months to a year. But for now, baby, we are in the clear.
All right, but you can never be too cautious these days, especially when it comes to money.
Hamp. How long have I known you, man? Fucking years. Have I ever let you down?
Other than the bank heist that you said was foolproof that got me locked up?
Now, you know what? That shit wasn't my fault. Why are you dragging that up after all this time? I had that whole thing set up on the inside. It was you, man. You and your people who screwed that up. So don't stand here and try to blame me for that. Mm-mm. Damn. Every time you try to take a nigga out of the hood, they end up being ungrateful. Man, Hamp, just shut up and stop your bitch.
Damn, man. Sounds like you're having trouble breathing or something.
What the fuck are you doing, Hamp?
Hey, you know? I'm tired of taking your shit, you know? Got my own plan. I don't have to listen to your shit no more.
Fuck you!
No, brother. I'ma fuck your wife.
You know, and sometimes people don't realize the man might be going through something. Maybe his money not like, you know, because like we from New Orleans, the best thing with me, I come from a hurricane town. So it'll wash everything away and you got to start over. I don't mind getting back up, picking up the pieces. You know what I'm saying? A lot of people don't want to do that. And you got to put better friends around you too. Because you look at Donald Trump, said in a speech a long time ago, he said, you know, I was $500 million in a hole. And I picked up the phone and I called one guy. And I had $500 million in my bank account the next day. Who can we call? Say, I need $5, $500, $5,000, $500,000. You think if you call, if you used to having all this money and you call one of your friends and say, man, I'm doing bad, dog, I need whoop, whoop, whoop to do this. I'm going to bounce back and I get, man, what? You're doing better. They're going to talk about you. They didn't do that to Donald Trump. They knew that he a hustler. He about making money. So, but it's having the right circle around me. And that's why I just start cutting some of my friends. I say, you know what? I got to have the right circle around me. Because when that hurricane comes, you got to be able to pick up the phone and whoever got love for you, they got to show that love. Especially if you've been, I mean, I've helped so many people. It hurts sometimes if you got it. Man, I need, woo, woo, woo. Man, for what? It don't matter for what. when you called me, I didn't say, I just sent it. Mm-hmm. And we got to clear our circle out if we got phonies and fakes in our circle. And I think that's what a lot of people are starting to experience, because everybody going to go through something. I don't care how much money you have. You know, you just got, you know, you might have a lot of money. I break this down to people all the time. A guy who's making thousands might think, I only got thousands. I need this to pay this bill. And he going through those thousands every month and he's struggling. A guy who got millions got bigger bills. That guy who got thousands might have a better life than that guy who got millions, because now he got to keep all this, the upkeep on all this stuff. He got millions, but it's going out every day. So everything he making, he coming right back around and spending and going back, trying to figure it out, trying to create more stuff. It depends what type of entrepreneur you is, a businessman you are or whatever, or what type of debt or what type of bills you have. So you might think, oh, I got all these nice houses, cars and all, but guess what? You got a lot of bills.
Thank you.